Hey, what's up, guys? Thank you for tuning in here. Today's video, I'm going to be taking a look at the new Marvel Legends Spider-Man Into the Spider-Verse Peter B. Parker figure. So this guy is part of the new Stiltman Build-A-Figure wave. You can see down here with the Into the Spider-Verse assortment, you've got Miles, Gwen, Peter, Prowler, and then two comic figures. You got the Red Hand Ninja and Frogman because, you know, Frogman, everybody's favorite hero. When's he coming to the MCU? But, you can get Stiltman here, get Red Hand Ninja. You can get a lot of him, and he comes with the leg piece to where you can build a super tall Stiltman if you're into that. But I really like this box because this just back portrait and all of the art they have for these figures, the Spider-Verse ones of this wave, is just gorgeous. So I really like it a lot. We got some like kind of haphazard Spider-Verse figures a few years ago when the movie came out. They were just repaints of Miles and Gwen. I didn't even bother with those, but so I'm really excited to actually have these. So let's go ahead and crack open Peter and see what he's like. And here we have Peter B. free and out of his box, and we also have all of his stuff. But all of his stuff, we're going to go ahead and save for here in a minute. The figure specifically, I want to go ahead and state a couple things. I like this a lot. I was kind of worried looking at him in the box because he kind of had just this stagnant, like with his arms straight. He had this stagnant look to him with the sculpt. I mean, it's obviously like a grippy hand. This here is like a really flat palm. So I was kind of worried about the stylized design being bogged down to a basic 6-inch retail figure, but it really isn't. It lends itself really well. The cuts and everything in the sculpt and the way the articulation is formed around it, it fits it all really well. The face sculpt is obviously really good. We'll get to all of it here in a moment more in detail, but off the bat, I'm actually pretty surprised with how he feels in hand. The other thing too, this is really cool that he has this. So he has got the boot and the sneaker because, you know, he had that in the film. I really like the fact that the figure has this detail, and it looks great. But unfortunately, I've had a heck of a time trying to get this guy in some poses and really stand him up. So, in this video, if you see him topple over and then a transition, it's because he does have some stability issues. Hopefully, it's not too bad. And also, I'd like to go ahead and show him with two other Spider-Man from Marvel Legends. You have everybody's brand new favorite, the Retro Spidey, and everybody's old favorite, Pizza Spidey, over here. So, this isn't really a comparison in my natural form. It's really just to see how these guys scale up, how this new Peter Parker, how this new Spider-Man scales up with the current Spider-Man, and he looks really good with them all. I'm a big fan of Spider-Verse shelves or displays and all of that, just kind of having everybody grouped together. I think he's really going to fit in with the bunch here. So again, it's not a comparison. These aren't the same Spider-Man, but just if you have an idea or are curious of how they scale up and look together. And for anybody curious, here is Peter Parker versus Peter Parker. This is the vintage Peter Parker figure from the wave last year. The head sculpt is that of the one from the all-new, all-different Spider-Man and Mary Jane 2-pack from Toys R Us, like 4 years ago or whatever. So it's not the retail one, but here are two basic Peter Parkers together. Again, this really is a comparison. They are two very different characters, very different versions of Peter Parker. But again, if you're curious how these guys are going to scale up on a shelf, if you're going to feel like you're overcrowding, here's an idea, and you can make that decision yourself. Now, I do have the Into the Spider-Verse Miles, but I don't have him out of his box just yet, so I'm going to save him to compare him for the Miles video with him, so you can check that one out later. But let's go ahead and get into his sculpt and everything like that. His sculpting in detail is very wonderful. His face sculpt, it looks like a scan, so I don't know if they have, CAD renders or anything like that, or, you know, maybe I'm just misunderstanding how that happens, but the kind of printed texture of the paint and in the eyes and everything really reminds me of what they'll do for some of the actual live-action casts. So whatever they did with this, it's just some really intricate sculpt and paint work. It works really, really well. The suit down here, let's go ahead and go out a little bit. His suit is really nicely sculpted in the bottom here. The one thing I do want to point out, this is going to sound silly. Some people may find it silly. But in the film, this Peter Parker, it was mentioned multiple times that he was more rotund in the tummy. And it bothers me kind of when companies who make merch of this Peter Parker and not really recognize that. But I'm really happy here because he does have a little bit of, love handles and a little bit of a more rounded shape to his stomach and kind of in the back here, which is hard to show on camera with the coat. But he doesn't have a completely flat stomach. They didn't just make him sculpted like every other Spider-Man or Peter Parker, which I appreciate. Again, this one is meant to have kind of that, that larger gut. I appreciate that sculpt. Down here on the legs, I really like how the sweats look. Like, it doesn't really look disjointed, but again, you can kind of really get those slouchy poses out of him with that angled look on how it's sculpted and cut together. Especially these hip cuts up here. Like, again, the articulation is actually really surprising. And then the detail detail on the feet and the shoesies is really, really nice. Peter B's accessories here. He does come with the Stiltman build figure head. I have not decided if I'm going to finish Stiltman here, but there's a look at that if anybody's curious of an actual look of what his head sculpt is going to look like. He also comes with a cup, so you can go ahead and give him something to drink. And he can just, get a little straw, he can sip. Yeah. That's kind of fun. I don't mean to be picky at all. I kind of wish he came with a burger. That would have been fun. But also, I'll take the cup. You know, nothing wrong with that. People get thirsty. He also has, we'll go ahead and leave that out. He also has an alternate head, so here is his completely unmasked head. And if you just decapitate him, pop on this other head here, he has another partial masked head. So I think it's interesting that he does not have a fully masked head, but that kind of tells me that they'll probably end up making an actual figure of the fully suited Peter B. But here's a look at this head sculpt. You can see he kind of has a different expression, which is something I'll bring up in my Miles video that I find interesting. But I do really like that he has that kind of like cocky smirk, and again, really emotes this character from the movie. It really translates from the screen to the toy very well. There's a sculpting on the mask, which is super, super nice. He also has alternate hands, so you can just go ahead and pop off these guys. These hands are the only ones that he has without gloves on, but you can give him fists. So again, if you like your Spider-Man, I'm not going to say it. You can go ahead and just give him actual fists. You can put up his dukes just like Spider-Man Noir. Again, yeah, fists. I'm pretty sure that these are all newly sculpted too. I don't think these are reuses of anything. I was kind of worried they were going to reuse the TASM 2 hands, but it does not seem to be the case. You can see all the webbing detail that is engraved and indented into those fists. Now, other than fisting, another thing a Spider-Man needs to do is thwip. So he does also ultimately come with thwip hands, and these are pretty great, but I do apologize. I don't have a complaint. I don't want to call it a complaint because it's fixable, and it's really nothing bad about the figure, but or anything like that. But these, again, are newly sculpted hands, it looks like. I was kind of worried they were going to reuse the TASM 2 hands, but it doesn't look like they did at all. And again, you can see the web detailing in there. Again, these thwip hands, they're proportionate to the body. They look really good, and the sculpt and the palm and everything like that looks great. My one small complaint is in the animation model, his hand did not have a slouch in it. They were actually able to pull off the full straight, you know, kind of cartoon look with a fully straight index and pinky, which I understand is kind of hard for people to do. So for the movie figures based on like Tom Holland, Tobey Maguire, it's a little more slouch. This is a cartoon, so I was kind of hoping that it would be a little bit more straight, you know, a la here he is with the retro Spidey hands here. But that's what I mean, as opposed to, you know, how they curl and don't curl. Something I can fix, I just gotta take a little bit of heat to it. This isn't really a complaint. I know some people are probably rolling their eyes. But again, that's just a little preference of mine. I always like Spider-Man to really be given it his all. Not really any of that right there. But hey, it is what it is. I can fix it. Peter B. here does have a surprising array of articulation. Now, I didn't think he'd be, like, unarticulated or anything like that, but he does have a surprising range of motion I didn't really expect. So, in his head joint up here, his head is on a ball joint, so it rotates 360. And you can move it downward that much. You can move it upward this much. Now, a lot of his joints on mine are super tight, and it is really nice because you can see the sculpting up here with the neck to the suit. It's a separate piece, but you can see it kind of wiggles around at the connection point, you know, if you torque that. So it's nothing that feels like it's loose or going to tear, but just a heads up to be a little ginger with that if it's as tight as mine. I don't want, you know, anybody kind of ham-fisting it and ripping the head off of the figure. I don't want you to do that. The shoulders rotate 360. They go in and out that much at the hinge. They rotate 360 at the bicep. His elbows here are extremely tight on both of my arms, but they are double jointed here. So again, you can get a really full range of his, you know, all of his articulation he needs to get his thwips going, whatever. His articulation and his torso is really nice because he's got this really nice ball joint system. So again, with his slouch and everything and his stance, his animation model, he can really, really get that. And it's smooth too. It doesn't feel super tight. It doesn't feel loose. And you can really get it to, you know, kind of cock the hips here because he has another ball joint system down here. So I really enjoy those cuts and everything like that. The legs are going to go up a good amount. They're going to go back a whole ton amount. The knees are super, super, super tight. The top one is pretty tight, and the bottom one is tight because they've got these weird grooves in both knees. Ooh. Yeah, this one is tight. I want to brace that. Yeah, no, that one's super tight. You can see they've got these weird groove carvings in here where, you know, it's the sculpt for the sweatpants, which is fine, but man, I didn't think sweatpants would be that egregious on the knees. Down here as well, he's got rotating. Oh, he's also got thigh swivels. Don't want to forget the thigh swivels. His ankles can rotate at the separation of the sweatpant. Both of them can. And then he's obviously got some ankle pivots and some rotation on the inside. So very, very nice. This dude, again, oh, his hands rotate and they're all on hinges. So this man does have some very, very nice articulation. He has no shortage. He's going to be able to do a whole lot of stuff, you know, some stuff that I really didn't see out of any of the promotional pictures. So I'm really excited to play with him and, you know, take a look to see what I can get at the end of the video. Heck. And that's pretty much all I've got to say here about Homeless Spider-Man. I think he's actually fantastic. I gotta be honest in the fact that he really did exceed my expectations. They did really, really well taking this stylized version of the character and translating it to a retail toy. So bravo over there to them for that. So they did really well. I gotta say too, my only really complaint with him is his stability issues. He's actually kind of leaning against the box here. So yeah, he can't even pull that off. Maybe it's my light box. Maybe it's off center. I don't know, but we'll see about that because when I had him on my other table in the other room, he really wasn't pulling off too much more. But hey, that's why you get a flight stand and get him in some fun action poses. But if you have any questions about him, maybe something I didn't cover in this video, feel free to leave a comment in that section down below. I'd be happy to get back to you as soon as possible. Please like this video if you enjoyed this content, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Thank you for watching.
Spidey bell, swinging through midtown. Oh, what fun to sling a web and take the bad guys down. Spidey bells, quipping all the time. Oh, what fun to swing around New York while fighting crime. Whipping through the streets of New York every night. Wrapping bad guys up in my web so tight. Crawling up the walls, making villains fight. What fun to make the holidays free from crime tonight. Oh, spider bells, goblin smells, vulture laid an egg. Spider buggy blew a tire and venom got away. Hey, spotty bells, swinging all the way. Oh, what fun it is to fight the bad guys every night.